Greetings, ladies and gentlemen, Smiling4 here, and welcome back to Kingdom Hearts Reverse Rebirth in Rechain of Memories. As in the last episode, we headed on to Twilight Town. All the places for Riku to go for exposition, Twilight Town. I guess it actually has, well, even if we're not in Sora's story. So yeah, we got ourselves some exposition as to what we're actually going to be doing here in today's finale, but if you guys don't know what I'm talking about, make sure to go check out that previous video. It had a lot more exposition than ever, I'll say that much. But anyway, today, the finale to Riku's story commences. We are tasked now with conquering our darkness once and for all. By taking on Ansem, the Seeker of Darkness. And hopefully this will go well for two reasons. The first being, hopefully this could be an easy fight. The other being, hopefully my software can endure us. Because right now, in between last episode and this one, I edited the... I updated it from the 32-bit to the 64-bit, which so far is doing well. It's having little hiccups every now and then with, say, the commentary. Like, the commentary bar just drops every now and then, more so than usual, I've noticed. So I'm hoping that's just a PlayStation 3 issue, and I'm hoping the thing does last, because when I tried to do this episode, the 32-bit version, you know, the other version of the software, I had much worse things than usual. Instead of, you know, that... Well, I had, like, a drop in between every sentence of mine. Just losing commentary, you know, just a lot of delay, and mixed in with the footage, and kind of frustrated me. It really did. And if this doesn't work, well then, I might be temporarily on hiatus, just for sheer fact that either A, my software is cramped, or maybe Elgato's, or B, the fact that my computer is finally about to die after, which I wouldn't be surprised with. But either way, let's see how far we can get with this. Hopefully it's nothing too, bad. I mean, heck, the, commentary hasn't even dropped a little bit ever since in the last maybe 30 seconds or minutes. Who knows? But anyway, we got one more card left. You guys know where to go this time. As always, Castle of Liberty. The most meta the entire game. Straight up, most meta.
Ansem! Where are you? Show yourself!
Someone's a little steamed.
I'll be here at the very heart of darkness, watching you plunge into the same darkness inside of you.
Of course, mocking us until the very end. Oh, well, just wait, Ansem. Your eternal sleep, I want to say, it's coming very close to an end. But yeah, here we are, Castle Oblivion as per usual. Although here's the main difference between this one and the one in Sora's story. Well, first of all, only two rooms that we have to use cards on. The one in front of us and the one after that. And then we just got a door for the boss, but yeah. Pretty short area. Also, I don't know how difficult the enemies were before, you know, in Sora's story, but here, they seem to become really annoying, like more so annoying than usual. Like, they will... Just two hits from a Neo Shadow can almost kill you. Not exactly my favorite moment, mind you. Oh, and a term, and just like Destiny Islands and Twilight Town, enemy cards from this world. Here you're just using what you have, which in our case is roughly 30 cards-ish. All, they're pretty powerful, pretty good stuff. You know, it's got some 4s, which I'm not a big fan of, a couple 3s, some 5s, but mainly 9s, 8s, and 7s, and 0, which will be very helpful when it comes to this final boss. Yeah, nothing else to talk about. Really? There's not really much I can say right here. You know, I'm avoiding everything entirely, you know. Oh, right. Got thrown a 2. Whoops. Thing is, ironically enough somehow, I am roughly the exact same level as I was when I first, you know, got to completing the game. You know, getting here to the Ansem fight and all that. I was level 40, and here we are level 38. So somehow, I've caught up with myself. When I'm in my free time, I usually go for every enemy that I come across, you know, fight everything that I can, level up, all that stuff. So, the fact that I'm roughly the same level here really, really says something. But anyway, before we go on, because right now I'm a little paranoid, this is exactly where the footage started cramping up for me. You know, the little errors now and then. I mean, again, not seeing too many things, hopefully it's not the case, but... Let's see, the Destiny Islands, but, yeah, I'm gonna save right here. I'm gonna save right here. That way, should something happen, I have something to go back to instead of having to go through the entire process of getting to the store all over again. So yeah, there we go. A few times you'll see me save on screen in reverse rebirth. And the second thing that, you know, makes this place different from Castle Oblivion, instead of that absurd... You have to do, you know, the red, the blue, and then the 99. All you need are cards that add up to 13. I take it they're trying to be symbolic there, but... I kind of think it works well. So all I have to do is I'm going to throw in a 7 and a 6. And then on the countdown of 5, we barge on through the door. Okay, not really. I'm not going to count down to 5. But I'll throw in the key card and let the fighting commence. It's 1-on-1. Time to show him that Little Mac magic. Even though we don't really have magic whatsoever.
I smell you, Ansem. Show yourself!
I have watched you fight. I know your strength. Your skill with darkness has grown. It has become more mature. And yet why? Why do you accept the darkness, but still refuse me?
Isn't it obvious?
You know you and I are similar. We both follow where the darkness leads. Indeed, we are the same. So why? Does some part of your heart still have a fear of the dark?
That's not it. The truth is... I just can't stand your foul stench!
Burn!
You are a fool. You should know my powers well by now.
Yeah, I know. Or did you forget? I used all the power you had to give. And Sora still beat me. I'm not at all impressed with your powers.
Neither is the entire Kingdom Hearts fan base.
In that case... You shall sink into the abyss!
Nice black hole trick there. I'll give you that one. Look familiar? So then, let's get this over with, shall we, ladies and gentlemen? Whoever may be watching this actual video. But yeah. Ansem, the Seeker of Darkness. Attempt number 3 in my case because of bad recording issues. So I'll try this again from the top. My recommendation for this fight is just to use the dueling system. Not usually the most my most recommended strategy, if only because I like to, you know, hit the guys with main cards as possible at once, you know, deal a lot of damage as quickly as possible.
This one's fine.
This fight, you basically are required to. Thing is, even if you decide to go the whole tank route, you know, attack him, deal as much damage as you can, endure his hits. Thing is, in my case, I tend to get knocked out much earlier than you would expect. So, the best thing I can recommend to someone who's barely leveled up their HP, you know, going for the DP and attack bonuses, just dual system. You can throw on them lesson cards, you know, boost the damage, and that's all you should need. You can also, I also do recommend Jafar and Boogie Boogie at some points, but right now that's not my main concern, because again, I'm just, you know, using the dueling system. Breaking every bonus card as soon as possible. And, you know, surprisingly works much more effective here than anywhere else, because, you know, he has 7s, 8s, 9s, 0s. At least we have enough cards to actually, you know, break him. Sure, that's not a lot, but it's good enough to actually get that barrage of blitz in there and just wipe him out, and I need to get these. As you look at this. Even when I went through half of the deck, I was able to still, you know, beat him in the dueling system without doing a single reload. So it really does help to actually go that route. One thing I do not like, though, is when he does that. Ah, that's probably the most annoying part of this fight. That little Dark Rush attack of his. Now, for whatever, I don't know why, but, you know, ever since I started recording this, you know, I've had troubles with this part. I really have. Whenever this happens, I tend to get wiped out, when I've never had this issue before, so what the actual heck? But yeah, that's basically the nutshell of the fight. I'll get cut right here, and I'll see you guys somewhere in the middle of it. You know, when we deplete half his HP. Okay? See you guys then.
This one's mine!
Come
see,
over your
much
heart.
Better this time around. Oh, now he's hunting me. Basically, attack him, he'll counter you. Easier said than done. So, my recommendation, do not, you know, fall to his temptations. It's as easy as that. Just keep on barraging and hoping for the best. Hoping he doesn't go into the dark aura mode. Yep. 1, 2... There we go. Oh, we actually got to the end of that one.
This one's mine.
Not exactly something I'm a big fan of, but can't really do much. Ooh, thank you for being only that.
Just me.
Oh, that would have sucked if there was something else. It really would have. 1-1-0-0-9. Great cards, there we go.
This one's mine!
Reload.
Come on.
Yeah, I'll take that hit, why not? Anything to humiliate you.
This one's mine!
Only one more bar of HP left, let's end it!
This one's mine!
I'm gonna do that!
The final darkness is not.
Ooh, okay, that works. Yeah, I don't recommend slice that often unless you're deciding to actually break his. That's the only time I can recommend it. Or if you want to be cocky like me, and just, you know, get him done and over with. Ah, man, it feels good to wipe this guy out. Especially since especially after the many failed attempts when I first played the game, and I was trying to actually formulate a strategy.
Insolent!
Handsome!
This How's that for insolence?
The end.
This is hardly the end. Your darkness. I gave it all to you. My dark shadow lingers. Someday, I will return!
Oh. Oh. Ah. Sora. Kairi.
The light.
Gosh, Riku.
Within the darkness.
I know you wanted to do this alone, but you don't mind getting a little help, do you?
I should hope not. And into the light from the darkness.
So, Riku, what happens next? Are you going home?
Oh yeah, I get the trophy for this.
I can't go home. Not yet. It's still here. It's really faint, but I can sense him.
So he wasn't kidding, then.
I think his darkness may still have a hold on me.
Your darkness belongs to you, just the same way your light does. Up till now, I thought darkness was something that should never exist.
And I can somewhat
then,
agree.
I spent time with you and changed my mind. The road you chose, I didn't know. Light and dark, back to back. With you, I think they might meet in a way nobody's seen before. Wonder where that road leads. I'd like to see myself.
As would I.
I'd like to walk the road with ya.
Your Majesty, I'm really flattered. I don't know what to say.
Gosh, Riku! You know you don't have to call me that now. We're pals.
Fair enough, Mickey.
The first time Riku actually says Mickey. Whether he's talking about the mouse or the glass drink. By the way, where did Mickey get his robes? I mean, we saw Diz give Riku his, but where did Mickey get his from? Unless they were just piled underneath Riku's.
What are you making me choose now?
Between the road to light and the road to darkness.
Neither suits me. I'm taking the middle road.
Do you mean the twilight road to nightfall?
No.
Not exactly.
It's the road to dawn.
And there we go, guys. Riku's story. Finally completed. Yeah, it feels good saying that. Yeah. I really don't know what to say. You know, Riku's story, you know, end up it being a bit shorter than Sora's, and heck, if we looked at my save file, it took half as long to actually beat Riku's story than it did Mickey's, you know, like 7, 8, 8-ish hours, whereas Sora's was like 14 to 15. So you can tell that Riku's is definitely much quicker in terms of what you're actually doing. Then again, maybe it has to do with the fact that they don't customize your own deck in this mode. But you know, for what it is, it's alright. You know, I like the concept of Riku's story, you know, fighting the darkness within him, and then the end, him going to the road to dawn, but honestly, considering what we went through, it makes me wonder what the point of the whole mode was. I mean, besides the obvious duel system, you know, the rapid card breaks, DP mode, it's relatively the same story, or the same game. You know, it's just limiting your potential. One thing I think would have been cool, you know, but this is just me, is if they, instead of making Riku's story a thing, there's like a boss rush with Sora, you know, you go through all the bosses back to back, and that in itself reveals a story. Or maybe they could release a story alongside Sora's, you know, as a little filler, but, you know, I honestly can't complain. I guess that's just me in a nutshell. And you know, I would talk more about, you know, why I think of the game in itself, but I think I already did that with Sora's story, but in case I didn't,
You know, gameplay, simple, you know, even if it is a remaster from a Game Boy style, I think it works. It does a great job in and of itself. You know, card grinding can be a bit of a pain if you don't know what you're doing. Leveling up can be a pain if you don't know what you're doing. Honestly, this is just a game that you need to learn about, you know, as you go on. That's how I see it. Anything that could apply to Sword Story can somewhat also apply to Riku's story, so that's probably the best way I can summarize it. So there we go, Riku's story. However, I'm not done quite yet. Now, if you guys remember a while back from Sora's story, you know, with the whole Hita Rewards card, I still haven't touched that, like, at all. And I plan on uploading, you know, these episodes way before that. So I'm gonna get to work on that, you know, as soon as I can. And that will in fact be the true finale to Re-Chain of Memories. You know, it won't be a boss fight because why would I do that? It'd be kind of pointless, especially since there's two stories and I don't want to throw both of those back to back. Because that would be just kind of a mess. Just going through two kinds of credits. Yeah. So I'll make sure to end these off with the true finale by getting those final Hita reward cards. And then, after that, well, you guys will just have to find it out by sticking around. But with that said, thank you guys so much for watching this episode of Kingdom Hearts Re-Chain of Memories. If you guys did enjoy, of course, as always, make sure to leave this video a like and comment down below. Share this video with your friends, should you feel the need to, and of course, if you are new here to the channel, want to see the quote-unquote true finale to Re-Chain of Memories as it comes out whenever it does, along with any other series I decide to throw into the mixer, then make sure you have in fact subscribed and join the Dread Knights and myself in this quest to collect the cards. Oh, that's right. Cutscene between Riku and Miki. A little something for you guys. But yeah, until next time, this is my Angel before signing out. Have a great rest of your day, take care, and I hope to see you guys tomorrow, or next time, with the true finale to Reverse Rebirth slash Re-Chain of Memories, whatever you want to call it. Until that day, I will see you guys in the next video.